Today we're talking about Sonny Perdue, one of the happiest guys in the Trump cabinet. Man, he looks like Don Rickles on antidepressants. So first, the elephant in the room. Sonny Perdue is our Secretary of Agriculture, and if Perdue's name sounds familiar, it's probably because of the massive chicken company Perdue Farms. But different Perdue. So why are we talking about Perdue today? Oddly enough, because of China.
China slapping tariffs on a number of American agricultural goods, including cheese and pork. U.S. hog production overseas is a big business. One in four U.S. hogs raised in the U.S. are sold abroad. China, one of the largest markets for U.S. pork, utilizing products American consumers wouldn't normally buy. China also slapping tariffs on soybeans.
China seems to have lost its appetite for American food, which is bad because we sell them a ton of food. I mean, our number one product to them was $16 billion worth of soybeans. And good luck selling billions of dollars of soybeans domestically. Republicans, maybe you can temporarily stop hating those condescending vegans for a few months and hope to heck that we can find some more red-blooded patriots willing to eat a bean with slightly less flavor than cardboard and the consistency of dissolved paper. Don't worry about not being able to find a vegan to thank either, because believe me, they'll let you know. Overall, China is, or was, our second largest agricultural export market, falling just behind our friendly neighbor to the north, Canada. Well, hey there, neighbor, can we have a little butter and about $20 billion worth of wheat and processed food? These large food tariffs from China are particularly damaging for middle American farmers. So, Sonny, what are we going to do?
The USDA has tools that in our toolbox. We are not disclosing all those right now. The market's dynamic. We have to determine what are trade disruptions or what are normal market volatility in order to make those calls.
Wow, now I'm suspicious about these undisclosable tools. Does the USDA have a hit squad? Either that's the answer, someone's hiding something, or we just don't know what we're doing. I mean, could you imagine how durable the market would react if the Department of Agriculture revealed to the public that they had a cohesive plan for dealing with the agricultural industry in a trade war? Don't worry though, because I looked into the topic, and since quite a few things have been announced, except, as usual on this show, no reporters are talking about this, because North Korea said they're regretting talking to the US, and, well, we wouldn't want to hurt their feelings, so let's direct our national attention towards that. Anyways, Sonny, let's talk about this plan, not plan. Well, unfortunately, even though the trade war was officially started on July 6th, Sonny is still being pretty coy about this whole thing. Although, we can look at what staffers are doing and get a rough idea of what it will look like. President Trump's aides are looking at ways to use Commodity Credit Corporation Charter Act. Wow, someone got really excited with the alliteration on that one. The CCC was a Great Depression-era strategy for helping farmers at a time when the cost of agriculture was zero. So yeah, farmers just kind of stopped caring and trying to limit supply to get the price up, which, during a time when no one could afford anything, wasn't great. This led the government to step in and guarantee a price floor. So if the price drops too low, the government will pay farmers the difference between what the food was sold for and an amount that will keep farmers producing food for years to come. Which is important because I live in a small apartment and I'm pretty sure my lease won't give me permission to start tilling my shared living room area. This CCC legislation also allows for the sale of agricultural commodities to each government agencies and to foreign governments and the donation of food to domestic, foreign, or international relief agencies. Basically, to keep the price up, governments can buy excess food and use it in aid. So, Africa, I smell a few billion dollars worth of soybeans coming your way. Sonny Perdue has explicitly looked into this, saying, "So while the CCC is part of the tool in there, it's not everything. That's why we are not laying out the whole playbook for the defense to look at. The tool you're thinking about isn't the only tool in the plan. Just another great reason for not telling us what's going on." It was reported by the Huffington Post that the CCC allows the Agricultural Department to borrow as much as $30 billion from the US Treasury that can be used to buy crops for farmers that would go unsold in a trade war. To put that number in perspective, because as a guy whose financial goals are pay rent at the end of the month, it it's a little hard to comprehend $30 billion. That's half of Puerto Rican debt, or 10 times as much as we spend on the EPA federally. Alright, so clearly that's quite the chunk of change. What would we be using it for? Well, the most likely strategy, according to ProFarmer.com, is the USDA could direct the CCC to purchase soybeans to buoy farmers' revenues. Well, problem solved. We buy the leftover soybeans. Well, of course it's not that simple, because people are asking, what do we do with all these soybeans? Well, we eat them, of course. Again, not that simple, because as Iowa State University economist Chad Hart pointed out, if the government buys corn, what are they going to do with it? Are they going to store it? Are they going to donate it? If you sell it, you compete with farmers selling their products. I mean, if you know the government's giving away billions of dollars in soybeans, but you're still willing to pay market price for it, well, then I have this great bridge in Brooklyn that I'd just love to sell you. Furthermore, you're giving it to people who these farmers would really want to be selling it to. So this is really bad for farmers. So seriously, what do you do with all these agricultural products? Well, you could destroy it all. And if you think that's a joke, watch this.
Dairy farmers in the U.S. have dumped more than 40 million gallons of excess milk amid a supply glut that has slashed prices and has warehouses filled to the rafters with cheese.
Now that would feel really, really weird, considering the most recent work requirements that the Farm Bill attached to getting food aid. Hey, maybe they could get jobs destroying food to qualify for eating food. Others have advocated for trying to turn soybeans into a fuel for military purposes, so as not to compete with traditional soybean farmers. I'm not even sure Kafka could describe such a perfect bureaucratic waste. We'll only buy food to ensure it won't be eaten. It is the solution to this problem though, because economics. We'll probably end up at least dumping some of it into foreign aid to a country that doesn't currently import American soybeans though. So at least someone will be able to eat healthy. The other solution that Sonny could implement would be Section 32 spending, which is similar to CCC spending, except that while CCC spending is made to stabilize the price of commodities to help the markets, Section 32 spending is made because, oh man, this farmer had some special crop he can't sell? Well, we might as well buy it. Because of this, Section 32 commodity purchases are categorized as entitlement. Alright, so what is the difference again? Because that was confusing as hell. Well, basically, CCC purchases are economists looking at a chart and saying, oh god, milk is too low priced. We need to buy milk and get that price back up. Well, Section 32 is Joe the farmer. He's Joe the plumber's distant cousin, telling the USDA that he wasn't able to sell his crop of kale, and the USDA stepping in and buying it to keep that farmer afloat. Because Section 32 funding isn't designated to keeping prices up, most of the food purchased through those programs is immediately given to help the Food and Nutrition Service Child Nutrition Program. So, woohoo! Some of the food will be eaten. Overall though, what is going to happen? Well, recently when meeting farmers in Spokane, Washington, Perdue said,
there's a legitimate anxiety over there about, do I sell my crop at these low prices? Or do I hold on or what? The mitigation strategy will hopefully give farmers some idea whether they should hold those crops or sell them and what they can expect from the government. My timeline for that is to give them some indication of that by Labor Day.
Yes, Perdue has a plan, but it's a secret plan that he's going to reveal by Labor Day because, you know, I'm not sure he has a plan, you guys. This Labor Day deadline raised a lot of eyebrows among certain farmers. Because come on, the trade war started July 6th when the tariffs went up. That's still 2 months away. I mean, this is cherry season right now. Farmers need to know whether to grow them or not. Although, seriously, don't grow them if your goal is just to sell them to the government for emergency economic funds. Like, good business move, but come on, I don't want my tax dollars going towards a scientist trying to figure out how to turn cherries into fuel. Although, we could finally make a true cherry bomb. Perdue did address those concerns by saying that any government help might be retroactive, so cherries and other commodities that suffer losses before Labor Day would be covered. That might be even dumber than buying food to destroy it. Hey, Perdue, I had a ton of cherries. Oh, they're all gone now, but trust me, it was a really good batch and nobody bought them. Why don't you just invest in Blockbuster gift cards so that we at least have something we can physically wad up and throw in the trash? Great, you'll retroactively help the price of the cherry commodity. Maybe if you go out and buy a house responsibly, you can retroactively solve the housing bubble. The moral of the story is, this trade war is hurting farmers badly, and the government won't start to help them until September. So go out and buy corn, soybeans, and pork so the government won't have to spend more than $30 billion additional tax dollars buying that same stuff in a few months. I personally know I picked up some extra blueberries at the store, so my Medal of Honor should be in the mail any day now. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, if you want to support independent journalism investigating Trump's cabinet, subscribe to our YouTube channel for our weekly episodes. And as always, thank you for watching.